Thank you so much for joining us on a brand new episode of 420 Grams. As always, हमारा जो त्रिदेव है, जयदीप बासु है, सिद्धांत आनीज है, and my name is Arjun. And there's another person who's joining us today for the show. His name is Tathagat Mukherjee. He's been the team director of the national team from the year 2009 to 2011. He's worked with the Delhi Dynamos. He's been in football for a long time. So of course, he understands what's happening on the ground. Tathagat, thank you so much for joining us on the show firstly.
Yeah, it's a pleasure, Arjun. It's good to be talking football on a Sunday afternoon.
Perfect, man. Nothing better than that. But my point being that this is something we're thinking of starting on a regular basis. All of you, of course, who watch our show, आप लोग कहते हो सर हमें पता नहीं चलता कि आपके वीडियो कब आ रहे हैं. मतलब हाइड एंड सीक चलते रहता है आपके बीच में और हमारे बीच में. तो हमने आज से ये शपथ हमने बड़ी खाई है, तो मैं शपथ तो बोलूंगा नहीं, पर आज से हम लोग ये ट्राई कर रहे हैं कि हर संडे वी गोइंग टू गो लाइव एट 4 PM ब्रदर एनी और 2 PM. इज दैट द स्लॉट? Yeah, your audio is gone, bro.
Yes, sorry. Am I back now?
Yeah, you're back.
Yeah. 2 p.m. every Sunday, which was the slot where that you were so ably occupying with your cricket show, which we are now taking over. We are reversing the trend.
Yeah, I am so all for football taking over cricket. May it continue.
Every Sunday, 2 p.m., NewsClick Facebook live.
NewsClick's Facebook page at Sunday 2 p.m. we're going to be going live. Just remember that. So we'll of course try putting it out. But if you guys want to join us and have a conversation with us, put in questions on Facebook, we of course will try answering your questions. And the reason we're doing that is because we realize, listen, we don't need to follow the news cycle. Internally, we've had a lot of these conversations. If something breaks in football, should we do a show a day after that? Or should we wait and make that one set time in the week? We will come and we will talk about all that's happened in the week before that. So Sunday 2 p.m., mark your calendars. Every Sunday 2 p.m. we will be coming to you live. But अगले संडे नहीं आए, नहीं आए, ये मुझे पता नहीं, मेरे को बोलना, क्योंकि हमारी ट्रैक हिस्ट्री थोड़ी ज़्यादा अच्छी नहीं है. Now the reason, of course, we've got Tathagat today is because we're going to be talking about some of these rule changes that have been brought about in Indian football, जिनमें से एक काफी time पहले हो गया था, which is the reduction of the foreigners in the league. The I-League will, of course, have 3+1 from the coming season. The ISL will have 3+1 from the next season. That means the season after, वहाँ से 3+1 का लागू हो जाएगा rule change as far as foreigners is concerned. Tathagat, I'll get straight to you, yeah. 3+1 पे आए. मैं national team की बात कर रहा हूँ, तो ISL का हमें अगर मद्देनजर रखते हुए, I-League एक साल पहले हो गया. Will it have a direct impact on the national team? क्या suddenly the fortunes of the team will change कि हमने तीन foreigner गिरा दिए?
देखिए अर्जुन, इमीडिएटली आप अगर एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे हो कि द चेंजेस स्टार्ट रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द नेशनल टीम परफॉर्मेंस, इट विल नॉट हैपन, राइट? सो इट्स अ लॉन्ग टर्म गेम एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. व्हेन यू गो बैक टू 3+1, आई मीन गोइंग बैक टू प्रोबब्ली जयदीप दा विल ऑल्सो कन्फर्म, दैट वॉज ऑल्सो द रूल अ डेकेड बैक, राइट? एंड द प्रॉब्लम वॉज you know, when I used to work with Bob and all the national team coaches, they had the same problem at that point in time. Where is it impacting? It's impacting Indian players playing in certain key positions. When we talk about the spine of a team, right? It's the central defense, the midfield, as well as the strikers. So it's going to be a long-term play here, and we have to be patient. The results will definitely not come overnight. In the next season as well, it will take a couple of seasons. I don't know how many seasons, it will depend. But there is another viewpoint which I have. We are saying 3+1, but what you also need to see is how many players are allowed to be signed, total foreigners that are allowed to be signed in the whole squad. 3+1 will play on the field, right? Now, hypothetical case would be if you are allowing 3+1 foreigners to be signed and 3+1 playing. So, you know, the 3+1 foreigners, we always know that I'm going to play for all the 90. So it's typical because at the club level, you are trying to win games. And that's what is most important for the club level coaches. So, if you want to really balance and create competition, even those 3+1 and give Indian players a chance to maybe play more games, you need to allow more foreigners to be signed, maybe 5 or 6, whatever. But 3+1 and possibly then start looking at reducing the number of foreigners from the following seasons. You know, 3+1, aaj striker ka problem hai India. Theek hai? Phir problem abhi dusra aa gaya hai. 10 saal pehle hamare paas acche defenders the. Aaj Sandesh Jingle hai, central defender. Uske baad kaun? नाम नहीं आते, अनस को उन्होंने रिटायरमेंट से निकाल के लेके आए, फिर ही प्लेड वन ऑफ द गेम्स आफ्टर एशिया कप 2019 ईयर आई थिंक अनाउंस रिटायरमेंट बट अगेन ही केम बैक एंड ही गॉट स्टीमक यू नो टोल्ड हिम टू कम बैक एंड यू नो सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द सेंट्रल डिफेंसिव स्पॉट बट वी स्टिल हैव द सेम प्रॉब्लम यू नो द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मोस्ट ISL टीम्स इज गोइंग टू बी two central defenders, one central midfielder and one striker, or possibly...
But that'll be the same for the I-League as well. I don't see that changing in the I-League, the structure, even if you go to a 3+1.
Absolutely. And that is where the problem is. Maybe in the I-League, you reduce it even more. After the new structure that has been announced by AIFF, where ISL is occupying the top spot, the second tier and the third tier leagues, and unfortunately, I-League is right now the second tier league, based on the announcement, maybe reduce the foreigners even more over there. So allow players like strikers or defenders to develop in the lower leagues and then possibly fight it out in the top league.
But you know what? Sorry guys, I'll just get you in. But Tathagat, whenever this argument is made, main to honestly aapko sach mein batau, main ek dost se baat kar raha tha. Main keh raha tha ki this whole pandemic that has played out, of course, and of course, you know, what's happened has happened and we're really sorry for what's happened and we hope it doesn't continue for too long. But it might have a positive impact on the league going forward. Foreigners are not allowed to enter your country. Then you might see an all-Indian team playing in the I-League and you might be forced into doing it. So you might be forced into playing that one season. And then you say, yeah, this is good. Because from their perspective, this is that when we don't play with our Indian player foreigner, how will it improve? Look,
Arjun, this is a forced change, right? It will happen in this season. I was having a discussion on the ISL teams this week. This year, you will see a lot of radical changes. But these are all forced changes. What is important is the sustainable change in the following years as well. Agle saal pandemic nahi hoga, fir se khul jayega, to foreigners aa jayenge. To aap kya rule to waise hi reh gaya. And as a club, I will like to, you know, take advantage of the rule. If it's 3+1, today I'm not being allowed. If foreigners are not coming into the country, ye saal theek hai. Agle saal kya?
जयदीप सर, मैं तो वही कह रहा हूँ ना कि आपने इस साल आपको फोर्स कर दिया गया है फॉर सम रीजन, आई एम सेइंग बाय अज्यूमिंग कि फॉरेनर्स नहीं खेल रहे, आपने पूरा लीग चला लिया विदाउट फॉरेनर्स एंड आपने कहा दैट द लीग हैज फंक्शन द वे इट वुड नॉर्मली फंक्शन, आई मीन द टीम्स आर स्टिल प्रीटी टाइट, द क्वालिटी ऑफ फुटबॉल माइट डिप इन ब्रेसेस बिकॉज सर्टन इंडिविजुअल्स आर नॉट प्लेइंग इन योर 11, बट इफ यू रियलाइज दैट लुक आई डोंट थिंक वी नीड 3 foreigners और 4 foreigners इन एवरी प्लेइंग 11, इट माइट जस्ट बेनिफिट I-League. मैं तो ISL की छोड़ ही नहीं रहा क्योंकि ISL का गेम अलग है, आप तो वहां पे ऑडियंस ग्रैब करने की ट्राई कर रहे हो who don't even follow football. I-League का तो वो सिस्टम नहीं है ना, वो तो कहीं बदरपुर या जंगलपुर के जंगल में खेल रहे होंगे कहीं ना कहीं, पॉइंट तो वही है कि आप लीग चला रहे हो वहां पे सर.
हां दैट इज ट्रू एट द सेम टाइम, सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट 3+1, आई डोंट थिंक ISL हैज गॉट इट 3+1. ISL हैज ओनली सेड दे विल प्ले 4 foreigners फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट ईयर. Not that they will play one foreigner from the AFC countries only. It's not that. 4 foreigners. And they will be recruiting 6 foreigners. And at the same time, should we, at least I will ask Tathagata, since he was also in the All India Football Federation, is it to some extent this 3+1 rule which has come to the I-League? Okay, let's take out ISL out of it to the I-League. Which the technical committee has taken a decision, I think a couple of months ago about it. Is it a kind of knee-jerk reaction? How necessary it is to follow the AFC rules? They have said it is up to the AFC rules. But how necessary is to follow the AFC rules? Maybe there are teams in Japan, there are maybe teams in other places who play with more foreigners, and when they come to the AFC, they play with 4 foreigners. So this 3+1 rule, in which has come, I'm talking about I-League especially, since it has come this season itself. Is it a knee-jerk reaction? Will it really help?
Jalita, I will not say it's a knee-jerk reaction, but it's a very convenient rule that has been adopted. It's a fact that 3+1 rule or 4 foreigners or whatever is only applicable when you play at the Asian or the continental levels. So you have... Every federation or every football association has the ability to decide how many foreigners are allowed in their leagues, whether it's a top league, second league, third league, whatever. So, I mean, saying that AFC is following that rule and it is a recommended thing, I don't think that's the case. And so, you can also have 2 foreigners or no foreigners. It's up to us. So, I think 3 plus 1 has been drastically reduced for the I League. I cannot really say what is the rationale behind it. Probably it's because the second...
But one team from the I League has a chance to play in Asia. Na? So I think that could be one of the reasons. If they are going to play, then you at least 3 plus 1 lagu rakho. Because ISL ka argument is that if you are playing 6 foreigners, 5 foreigners, suddenly you are going to Asia and they are going to 2 foreigners, then you are going to show you some pattes there.
यार फिर तो मतलब फिर आप कोई भी फॉरेनर मत खिलाओ सिर्फ एएफसी के टाइम पे कॉन्टिनेंटल लेवल पे जाके चार फॉरेनर खिलाओ आपका क्वालिटी बेटर हो ही जाएगा सो इट्स लाइक दिस आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग थ्रू आउट द ईयर फॉर द एएफसी कंपटीशन आई डोंट प्ले एनी फॉरेनर्स एंड द इंडियन प्लेयर्स आर गेटिंग ग्रेट गेम टाइम एंड ड्यूरिंग द एएफसी टूर्नामेंट सडनली 4 फॉरेनर्स कम एंड आई गेट द कोच हैज बेटर ऑप्शंस राइट सो
या बट दे वोंट ब्लेंड इन ना तथागत
टू द कोच सो आई थिंक there has to be some strong logic why we have to follow 3 plus 1. The technical rules, I somehow don't understand why it is 3 plus 1. If you really want to develop the game for the clubs as well as for the national team, at least at the lower level, reduce it as much as possible.
See, I will try to say one more thing, Arjun, in this. The 3 plus 1 rule has been brought in. It has been again and again said ki it has been done for the development of Indian players, which Tathagat was just talking about, that more and more Indian players will be. Is it a way to give Indian players more game time? Or you should look at things, how to increase the number of teams in both the leagues so that the Indian players get more time. That should be the first priority of the technical committee instead of just copy-pasting a rule which has come from AFC and say that Indians will get more.
तो वो मैं I'm sorry so मैं मतलब this conversation will go on but हमारे भाई वहाँ बैठे हैं आज किताबों के पीछे किताब दिखा रहे हैं कि पढ़े लिखे हैं तो सर क्योंकि आप वहाँ वो फ्रेम आपने बनाया है अगर आप फेडरेशन के टॉप बॉस थे और डिसीजन मेकिंग आपके हाथ में थी तो फिर आईएसएल छोड़ दो सर सर आईएसएल छोड़ दो आई लीग एंड द डिविजन्स बिलो क्या आप कहते हैं कि फॉरनर निकालो नो फॉरनर्स ऑल इंडियन टीम्स प्लेइंग
Yeah, I mean, we've talked about how we perceive like the whole foreigner situation, and that in an ideal situation it should be based on merit. ठीक है कि अगर आपको लगता है कि आपका एक किसी भी position में in your team you have something falling short, then you look for players from outside. Ideally, in a country as big as India, especially lower division clubs should be focusing on their own catchment area. Wherever they are based and in their sort of region, maybe of course it can't be only that particular town or whatever it might be, but in a very specified catchment area so that then your expenses are not skyrocketing, you know, you are not bringing in players just for the simple purpose of winning a particular league or just winning some games. But you're creating an overall environment where local players are coming through the system, getting a chance to play for a local club and fans are then supporting them, etc., etc. Right? So, if in the situation that doesn't happen, that's when you need to import for talent or players. Right? Whether it's a Chandigarh club importing talent from Manipur or from Europe or Africa or any other part of the world. Right? So, If I were the boss of the AFF, God forbid, ऐसी नौकरी किसी को ना मिले
सबसे पहले भाई सबसे पहले तो हमारा शो नेशनल शो बन जाएगा फिर पहले बनाएगा
but I completely agree with what Jaideep kind of quickly brought in that I would much rather have a bigger competition with 20 clubs and see that as the way to give Indian players a chance to play more games because even if you have this 3 plus 1 rule like we've discussed so many times the spine of the team will like and you guys were saying just now as well the spine will remain imported talent and in the case where if in your squad you are only allowed to sign that many foreigners then ideally actually the competition I disagree with Tathagat on that point that I think the competition should be from the Indian boys saying that we are better than these foreign signings that you brought in so we want to make a but that doesn't happen and that's
mindset hai sir yeah, mindset nahi badalna
mindset hai but they have, I guess they are brought in at much higher salaries yeah. They are brought in because they have played at a much much higher level you know in their development like we're talking about you have to go back to grassroots then right कि जो 10,000 घंटे आपको लगते हैं एक प्रोफेशनल प्लेयर बनने में बिफोर द एज ऑफ 18, वो इन लोगों ने बिताए हैं ना, whether they are coming from structures that are based in on the European continent or South America, where like there is a lot of football going on and people are getting a chance to play competitive fixtures. So having a 3+1 rule without expanding the number of teams and the number of games each team is getting is not going to solve the problem. And now because of the other structural changes that are coming in, where we are creating that like licensing criteria, for example, I agree that licensing criteria is important to some extent and it needs to be followed, because otherwise people will do whatever. There has to be some criteria to pick. But at the same time, it precludes so many local clubs, so many community-based clubs from even entering the competition. If you say that you can only play if you pay, right? That is always going to preclude tons of clubs across the country from playing football, and therefore preclude players from getting game time as well. So these are the changes that I would try to make. Expand. See, because also abhi kya hai, there's a ladai at the top.
हाँ भाई, but
आपको promote करना है top league, ठीक है? तो क्यों कोई सोचेगा I League को कैसे बढ़ाएं? Like भाई, जो foundation है उसको बढ़ावा कैसे दें? हम सिर्फ top division ऊपर से सोच रहे हैं ना?
मैं कह रहा हूँ जो आप अभी यहाँ पे कह रहे हैं कि टीम बढ़ाइए, मैं तो कह रहा हूँ सर तथागत प्लीज दिस इज फॉर यू कि अभी जो हालात हैं उसके हिसाब से बोलो ना जरा। हालात का मतलब ये है कि सडनली आपकी 16 टीम 18 टीम नहीं होने वाली जनाब, ये टसल चलने वाला है थोड़ी देर और चलेगा, क्या होने
नहीं होंगी, बिकॉज वो आपका लाइसेंसिंग क्राइटेरिया
जो भी है, जो भी
कह रहे हैं आपको इतने ज्यादा पैसे ही खर्च करने हैं तो वो कभी नहीं होगा ना। तो हमें डिसाइड करना है कि हमें टेलीविजन प्रोडक्ट चाहिए या हमें एक्चुअली अपॉर्चुनिटी देनी है कि आज अगर 400 प्रोफेशनल फुटबॉलर है हिंदुस्तान में, कि 10 years डाउन द लाइन वी वॉन्ट दैट नंबर टू गो टू 4,000। Ye, it's a very clearly different set of priorities, and that would be the discussion I think could be a possible point to discuss for the people who are making the decisions.
See, my only thing is, of course, that is ideal case scenario, 10-year project that say 40 clubs goes up to 400 clubs. I'm just taking a number like that, right? 10 years.
Yeah, like so often we've talked about how Spain, there are 9 leagues.
Theek hai bhai. But my point is, in those 10 years, say by year 5, you've touched 100 clubs and whatever, those 5 years, like no one keeps talking in these 6 years because you've adopted that 6 foreigner rule. If you take into number of teams, 7 or 8 teams, and you take out the number of chances, at least 24 players could have played 6 more years, right? I'm saying in the short term, Tathagat, in the short term at least, aap at least 2-3 ladke per team ko chance to de rahe ho. So that is at least a decent thing. ठीक है ना?
Absolutely. आप अभी क्या है आपका ISL या I League में five foreigners were being allowed to play, right? आपने अभी 4 कर दिया, तो आपका बढ़ गया 1 per team, 1 Indian more per team. So that means essentially 10 more players on average will play minimum.
Yeah.
At least
they
will get a chance. That's great. But the point is it enough? Or how much time will it take? And as Joydeepda is saying, increase the number of clubs. Yes, that's the ideal scenario. What he's trying to say is increase the quality of matches. Sorry, quantity of matches. Zyada quantity badhao matches ka. That can be achieved not only by just increasing the number of clubs, but at least like what the ISL was thinking about was having 27 games this season. Jo hua nahi hai is baar. Agle saal karne wale. So maybe that should go down. That should increase to possibly 36 games. 10 team mein khelo. 36 matches hi khelo. What at the end of the day, what we need to really assess is the number of hours Indian players are playing, or number of minutes Indian players are playing compared to the Asian counterparts. Whether it is coming through number of clubs or whether it is number of matches, we just need to figure out the right way. If 3+1 is one of the levers that you are pulling to increase that, then great. That is one. But there are many other levers. प्लस अभी दूसरा प्रॉब्लम हम जो बोलते हैं ना कि नेशनल टीम पर्सपेक्टिव से कि इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ क्लब्स, यू नो इट्स द अदर चैलेंज इज यू आर इंक्रीजिंग द डिमांड सडनली। आपने क्लब्स बढ़ा दिया, 4 क्लब या 2 क्लब बढ़ा दिया, प्लेयर्स कहाँ से मिलेंगे मुझे, सप्लाई कहाँ है फिर? और सप्लाई में जो चैलेंज आता है club owners, at the end of the day, they are thinking about winning the game, about commercial sustainability. वो कहते हैं कि मैं अगर 100 रुपए भी दे रहा हूँ, am I getting value for that? So that is the club's angle of it. So clubs, आप clubs के ऊपर ठोस दोगे कि ये national team को जिताने के लिए या उसका improvement करने के लिए, वैसे नहीं हो. You have to find a balance at the end of the day. Just by increasing, you cannot create a shock in the market.
Can I ask you, so when you were, of course, with the Dynamos, and I'm just saying, say, for example, 60 players are playing in the ISL or 70 players are available in that entire ISL thing. Do you suppose the Dynamos ever thought that out of these 70, maybe a total of 100 players, Indian players, are good enough to play in that level? कि सिर्फ वही 50 हैं और मैं बाहर कहीं जाता हूं तो वो उस लेवल के लायक है ही नहीं या मेरे को टैलेंट मिलता ही नहीं है बाहर?
बहुत चैलेंज है, बहुत ज्यादा चैलेंज. इफ यू सी द डायनामोस, अगर आप देखोगे फर्स्ट सीजन हमने ड्राफ्ट में काफी यंग प्लेयर्स उठाए, काफी सारे अंडर 21, आई थिंक वी हैड 6 or 7 प्लेयर्स, बिकॉज यू नो विद ऑल ड्यू रिस्पेक्ट टू इंडियन प्लेयर्स, एट द एंड ऑफ द डे हमें देखना है कि व्हाट इज माई आरओआई व्हेन आई एम सिलेक्टिंग अ प्लेयर. 1 crore देके मैं अगर प्लेयर उठा रहा हूँ तो आई वुड एक्सपेक्ट आई वुड गेट द सर्विस ऑफ अ फॉरेन प्लेयर, राइट? 1 crore इन एसेंशियली द टर्म्स इज $140,000. Which is like for a 10-month season is $14,000. That's a lot. I'll get a better, very good foreign player at that rate. So you have to understand the market economics as well. So then, you know, we analyzed and we said, fine. And our owners wanted to build a project for a long, long term. So we decided we'll pick some young guys who we think we can mold and it becomes easier. Yes. Now in that case, in wo balance karne ke chakkar mein, our performances were not that great. And towards the end of the season, every season, in 17, 18, 18, 19, we started doing well. It's not only the foreigners, the Indians also started blending in. And it is there for everyone to see last season what Odisha did. They were one game away or one win away from qualifying. So it was paying off at the end.
So, mota mota, Jaideep sir, ye hai ki, it's the coming together of a lot of things. एक 3+1 आपका नेशनल टीम नहीं करेगा, बहुत सारी चीजें. एक तो डिमांड के लिए सप्लाई बनाना, आपका यूथ सिस्टम आपको ठीक करना पड़ेगा, लोकल लीग आपको ठीक करनी पड़ेगी.
सो दैट्स व्हाई लाइक व्हाट द एनर्जी जिम्मा फेडरेशन को भी मेनी हाउ मेनी यूथ लेवल टीम्स आर कमिंग इनटू सिस्टम एंड इवन नाउ वी आर सीइंग बिकॉज़ आई सपोज आल्सो द पे एंड प्ले मॉडल इज वन ऑफ द फ्यू मॉडल्स दैट पीपल आर फाइंडिंग इज लीडिंग टू द काइंड ऑफ इकोनॉमिक सस्टेनेबिलिटी दैट Tathagat was referring to. So therefore, the youth clubs are increasing in number, and I think the AIFF is organizing inspections for 50 new academies that want to be empaneled in the system. So, wahi hai na, agar aapka approach ground up hai, to like you were saying, of course, aap aise shock nahi create kar sakte ki aapne Premier League mein suddenly 5 naye club dal diye. Kahan se aayenge players? Sahi baat hai. You'll have to look elsewhere. You'll have to look outside to bring in that number of just workforce. But at the I-League level, at the second division level, the numbers can, and because it takes much less to get in at that level also. If I own a club, to play at the second division level or a state league level, state leagues need to be encouraged, have more teams at the state level, and so on and so forth. Tabhi to niche se hi to aayega yaar.
जयदीप सर, फिर तो ये तो 25-30 साल का काम है, ये तो इजीली 25-30 साल का सर.
आल्सो आई थिंक सॉरी जस्ट वन थिंग ऑन दिस 3+1 थिंग, आई थिंक इट्स अ रूल दैट वी हैव काइंड ऑफ अडॉप्टेड फ्रॉम यूएफा एसेंशियली, बिकॉज़ यूरोप हैज ट्रेडिशनली बीन बिकॉज़ इट्स द सेंटर ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड द फुटबॉल बिजनेस एंड विद द बिगेस्ट क्लब्स व्हिच अर्न एंड देयरफॉर पे द बिगेस्ट सैलरीज. So everyone wants to go and play at Barcelona and Real Madrid and Manchester United and all of these clubs. Notice I'm not mentioning the banner club that you have removed from your room, Majan Pandit.
I have removed
tenth place this season, huh? Maybe even lower. Anyway,
they're playing the Pauri Garhwal League. खेलने आ रहे हैं वापस.
So because of the number of people that want to overall go and live and work etc. in Europe. They had to restrict the number of foreign players, and because of EU nationality, so all of everyone who is European in any case is a local player, right? So therefore, these kind of quotas have been borrowed from there without, I don't think, necessarily adapting them to the Asian or the Indian football ecosystem or environment in any way. तो ये है कि ठीक है ऊपर से आ रहा है तो आ रहा है, ले लिया हमने, उठा लिया हमने भी, रूल रख लिया एंड वी होप फॉर द बेस्ट। एंड प्लस पीपल लाइक अस जो चिल्लाते रहते हैं ना कि क्यों इतने फॉर्मर खिला रहे हैं खिला रहे हैं,
हम
लोग को चुप करने के लिए, हम लोग को भी चुप करने के लिए मे बी
अबाउट till a few months ago, you were involved in the club. All three places, which are the three main, spines, as you said about, of Indian football. Have you seen any attempt for long-term planning in any of them? Can you specify one by one?
Yeah,
that's a very hard question, I know. But
yes. I'll start with AIFF only, chronologically. I think AIFF, again, if you go back to 2009 and pre-2009 days, actually, when Bob and team basically came into the country, there was long-term planning, right? Yeah, the National Team Youth Development Program started then, back in Goa. And then you had these players like Sigurpi, JJ and all, who were scouted way back in the late 2000, in the later years of 2000, right? And then they went into the Indian Arrows program. So Indian Arrows, of course, it was a stopgap arrangement, but now it has become a long-term plan. Actually, you have to restart the Arrows a few years back again, because the problem that existed back 10 years back is still existing today. So I think that is a long-term project. The academies or the AIFF academies itself were a good idea to start them at different regional levels, but you know, it did not continue for whatever reasons. I don't know, maybe it was financial or whatever. So I think that was a long-term game at the end of the day, and it still is a long-term game with Indian Arrows continuing today. You still, most, if you see the demand of Indian Arrows players in the ISL and I-League, that kind of is a testimony to the success of that.
Yeah.
And that was conceived way back in 2010, a decade ago. Coming to Delhi Dynamos, yes, there was an element of long-term planning. Not with the first team, yes, we had to pick up young players, young Indian players, and they are producing results. They are continuing with the club. That is very, very important. But at the youth level, what happened is we had this tie-up with Aspire Academy. And with Aspire is one of the best academies in the world, sports academy, not only football. So we kept on sending some of the kids over there. What has happened on the project, I don't know currently with Odisha FC. But some of the kids who have come back and they have started joining the first team. Shubham is an example where, of course, he's not our product. We cannot call Shubham as our product. But at least after the rejection of the Under-17 World Cup, we picked him up. He was, you know, down completely, mentally very down that I could not make it into the Under-17 World Cup team. He was a Delhi boy and Odia. So luckily, he has fit into Odisha also. So we sent him to Aspire, and I think he played nine international games over there.
So far, 18 people are watching right now. Two people have commented. So I'm going to talk about them. Kashyap Shyani saying, now entire I-League will be hosted only at one venue. Number of teams in the league can be increased by 3 to 5. Jaydeep sir, you want to take this?
Tathagat update. He's just got bijli issues. He'll be back in a minute. So.
Okay, sir. So 3 to 5, वो कह रहा है कश्यप. 3 to 5 realistically कब कितने साल में बढ़ा सकते हो आप 3 to 5? चलो इस साल आपका एक आपका आ रही है license के through एक team. तो अगर आपको दो और team बढ़ाने हैं, मैं कह रहा हूँ 3. Let's keep a small number. तो how many years? 3 more, 2 more years, or 1 more year?
I think they will not take more than one team a year. I think. I think it will take 3 years, and by 2024, Arjun, they, as per the last year's that blueprint which they gave, which of course they keep on changing. Then I League and ISL both are joining hands, and by 2024 becoming one league.
Yeah.
So we are not sure what will happen in the next 2 years, isn't it?
Not one league. It's just the promotion relegation block.
Promotion relegation starts.
Which means essentially your one leg, like the English league has full structure.
So what will be the character of the League One? That is at the moment will be very difficult to say, because League One might have the character of the current League Two. A second division league also. So okay. I think from the next year, they will not increase more than one team as far as I believe. They will not.
Possibly the only scenario could be that if, say, East Bengal ka is saal ka to band ho gaya, if they go away up to ISL, then possibly their one more slot opens up. And that possibly would be another license slot only. It won't be someone coming on merit, I'm guessing.
Another point is which I thought has become a weak point of Indian football, that every time you want a team, you need an investor.
Hmm.
You just can't make a team and start playing football and play good football and come in. You have to have a bit of an investor who can spend some money on you.
But that is also to protect the team, sir. Because aap aisa na ho na ki you fold up suddenly. So at least an investor and money guarantees you that you'll have, you know, some succession over a couple of number of years or something like that.
That is true. I agree with you. But at the same time, despite having investors, the number of teams folded up, I think more than the teams who have folded up without investors.
If you
look at it. And the latest example is Coes East Bengal. Well, look, I am not saying that East Bengal, of course, that East Bengal has folded up. My house will be attacked. I know.
The partnership.
But the partnership has folded up. Arjun, you have seen what has happened to Salgaonkar. You have seen what happened to JCT, to Dempo, to Mafatlal, to Leader Club, to Mahindra United. So many clubs we can talk about. The entire Harut League in Bombay, they all had investors. Not the investors in the current way, but they had their big
backers,
corporate backers.
Mm.
And many of them have went back. At least one of them had clearly told me once, I am going out only because of the licensing criteria. He told me very, very clearly. He says, if I have to have a separate balance sheet, and that is going to show losses, as Indian football is. And I cannot go back to my board of directors again and again and tell them, throw them and show them my balance sheet. And they will start asking me that why are you running this team?
Yeah,
he said previously everything was hidden. I was running the team on the pretext of my. It was only a company to me. All the expenses were hidden in it.
Hmm.
But now I am a separate entity. And if the separate entity is not making money, if the separate entity is continuously losing money, then my board of directors has every right to ask me that why are you spending so much on money.
Fair point, sir. So, Tathagat, welcome back. Bro.
I'm sorry, guys.
No, that's okay. I think Shubham only cut the electricity at your house.
No. I don't think so. I think the moment he approached the discussion on Coes East Bengal, he himself switched off the electricity.
Yeah, I'm very smart.
Before I come back to you, Tathagat, just because we only had two people who commented on the show. It's so popular. I must give them that respect. The second person is a dear friend of the show. Mr. Annie, this is for you, bhai. His name is Anuj Gupta, my brother, who might hopefully, let's see if he sees the I-League or not this season. He's written, it's important budget sanction for top 10 state association run senior division. In this level, the 18 to 22-year-old talent should get 30-odd matches, which acts as the regional leagues promoted to the second division. According to me, the success in European and Japan model has always been the competition at top regional level and the tier 3-4 national level. So basically say, niche ka jo aapka jad hai na janab, jad mein paani dal lo banane ke liye.
So aur kya, kaise, matlab, agar koi phool ugta hai ya patte ugte hain, hawa mein thodi ugte hain. Jad se hi kahin na kahin to jad to lagani padegi na. And aisa bhi nahi hai ki ye India mein football ke liye ye koi, matlab, it's some big secret ya pehle ye nahi hota hai. There have been, for long periods, the team that you were sort of heading, Tathagat, at that time, maybe not at that time, but like a few years before that, there were players on that team who were playing 30, 35 games a season, combining the Calcutta League as well as the I League. And
you're talking about the national team that when he was part of.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So it's not that we have to like reinvent something, or we in all the conversation that happens around money in Indian football, we've somehow forgotten that like we have to also play a bit of football. It's like there's I get that like it's the driving force of everything, but.
वही है ना सिद्धांत. That's what I'm saying. It's a long term play. आप पेड़ उगाओगे, आपको टाइम चाहिए और उसके लिए पेशेंस चाहिए. पेशेंस इज की. एंड एवरी सीजन आप चेंज नहीं कर सकते. अभी आपने 3+1 भी चेंज अगर किया है तो आप उसको कंटिन्यू फॉर फ्यू इयर्स.
बिल्कुल.
एटलीस्ट कीप इट फॉर सम हैव सम कंसिस्टेंसी. आई थिंक इट्स 3+1 इज अ वेलकम स्टार्ट एंड जस्ट सी हाउ यू कैन रिड्यूस इट एट अ लोअर लेवल. व्हाट अनुज इज सेइंग इज द एब्सोल्युटली राइट थिंग. वी डोंट टॉक अबाउट स्टेट लीग्स. और स्टेट लीग्स में अगर आप देखोगे कैलकटा फुटबॉल लीग, ओके इट्स कैलकटा सेंट्रिक, इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल स्ट्रक्चर, फैंटास्टिक स्ट्रक्चर. बट अगेन अनदर एंगल दैट कम्स टू प्ले इज दैट बिकॉज यू हैव द फर्स्ट टीम ऑफ से ईस्ट बंगाल व्हिच हैज टू प्ले द कैलकटा फुटबॉल लीग बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स हिस्ट्री एंड द कमिटमेंट्स टू IFA एंड देन यू हैव टू प्ले द आई लीग. स्टेट लीग शुड कंटिन्यू थ्रू आउट द ईयर. इट कैनॉट बी ओवर 2-3 मंथ्स पीरियड. लाइक
घर पे स्क्रीन को देख कर बोलना आसान है, पर जो लोग ये टीमें चला रहे हैं, और मैं तो कह रहा हूँ बहुत कम पैसा, जो पैसे भी नहीं देते खेलने के लिए, पहले तो उनको रिस्पेक्ट देना चाहिए. अगर वो लोग कह रहे हैं जनाब हमारे पास पैसे नहीं है, हम कहां कहां से इकट्ठा करके, यहाँ पे दिल्ली की आपने बात करी, 7-8 बेनिफैक्टर्स गेट टुगेदर, स्मॉल टाइम बिजनेसेस, दे गेट टुगेदर एंड पुट दैट मनी.
तो क्लब वही होता है ना भाई.
बट भाई अगर आप, आई एग्री विद तथाकर, इट शुड बी अ मच लॉन्गर लीग, बट देन द बैंग ऑन द फर्स्ट आर्ग्यूमेंट दैट कम्स इज हाउ विल दिस लीग सस्टेन इटसेल्फ, हु इज गोइंग टू पुट द मनी. सो दैट इज माय एंटायर थिंग. कहां से आएगा वो पैसा?
बहुत डिफिकल्ट है.
But in 10 years, if we manage to sustain it, पहले क्या होता था institutional league. Anyway, Tathagat, you go first. यार मैं तो बात करता ही रहता हूँ.
नहीं मैं सिर्फ बोल रहा था, just what I'm trying to say is it's very difficult to balance sporting objectives and commercial objectives. Very very difficult. It's a very fine line. So we have to, since this pandemic is forcing us to have radical changes, maybe it's time for radical change and probably prioritize sports, sporting objectives. Possibly there's a sign with this 3+1 rule. Model ko bhi theek karna hai aapko. Economic model.
Bilkul karna hai. Like jaise pehle local leagues kaise chalte the? Largely it was driven by institutional, like Jammu and Kashmir, Delhi. Your audit team, for example. So all the departmental teams that were allowed, now to institutional teams are not even allowed to play.
Yeah.
No, it's not in Delhi.
I'm talking about ये हमारे जो national level league.
हाँ
पे. Right. So therefore, which means that the armed forces, where there's, for example, a culture of physical education, physical training, and they like to win things. I mean, they like to show that whether it's Olympic sports or football or whatever, right? But they can compete. So they can compete at the Santosh Trophy for the national championship. But they cannot compete in a league. Whereas you would remove, they would meet all your life criteria anyway, because they have the grounds, they have the financial wherewithal, etc., etc. Right? But because we want to take ownership of top level clubs out of public hands and put it into private hands, right?
Yes.
The motivation to be in the business is to be in it for a profit motive. Then you're going to have a clash. If you look at second division clubs in Spain, Italy, France, Germany, England even, how much money do they make? They require the championship in England. Relegated clubs require parachute payments of something to the tune of £60 million. They get a parachute payment. I mean, that's a figure that can run Indian football for 10 years. what one club receives. So, like, the money to theek hai, hum karte rehte hain baat is baare mein, but there are methods, there are ways in which, so the minute you've removed, why am I talking about institutional teams? Because you've removed the load of wages from whoever is organizing that club. If, let's say, four of us, right, want to play in a team, we all have jobs, we get the opportunity to play in a local league, where, like, for example, my brother is playing in some New South Wales, he lives in Australia. So he's playing in the third division of the New South Wales League, right? He gets to train, plus he gets 2 games a week now because seasons have been condensed. So he's saying, "Main to 4 din khel raha hu hafte mein, wo to bahut khush hai life se," but it's not his job. So playing football is also necessary, not just from a professional point of view, I think. And of course, we are talking top level national team, bhi kya impact padega. But jo impact padega wo to humko pata hi hai ki short term mein, like Tathagat is also agreeing, 2 saal mein 3 saal mein to nahi hone wala hai.
There is I think, Arjun, there are another thing, Arjun, which I believe that as we are talking about short term planning, and which we all agree with in tandem that there should be long term planning, like Tathagat was telling us, which all of us agree, there is also short-term investment in Indian football.
Yeah.
That is also there. Because the people who are coming in with money, they want their money back within a couple of years sometimes. And they're very frustrated if the result is not coming. They cannot be told that 10 team mein ek hi jeetta hai. Delhi League mein 16-18 team khelta hai, ek hi team league jeetta hai. Ye ho nahi sakta, 2 teams will win. It is not like 1968 Indian Olympic hockey team, which had a joint captain. that happened only once because of politics. So, since I will ask Tathagat about, again, I'm coming back to my favorite topic, Coexist Bengal, which is, I think, epitome of short-term investment.
Yeah.
In the current scenario. Does he think that Indian investors are have any long-term planning in their mind?
Jayita, we cannot generalize and say Indian investors. We have very good examples like JSW Group, then Tata Group. They are also Indian investors at the end of the day. They have at least, conceived projects which are long-term, at least.
It looks so far.
Absolutely.
It looks so far.
At least they have built the whole football chain, right? Right from the grassroots, the under-7, under-19 teams, to all the way to the senior team. They're at least trying. Tata has just done that 2 years back with the formation of Jamshedpur FC. And of course, they have center of excellence now. Yes, it's very challenging to find, long-term investors. And for that, the other lever, if you really want to increase more number of teams, as you said, that there should be more number of clubs in professional level football, the commercial model has to be sustainable. Till last season, I think all the ISL teams were bleeding. Every season, I think what is happening is that we are plugging the bleed to an extent. The losses are reducing every year. So that has to drastically improve year on year. For that, again, it's the commercial brains that we need to work out a model which is, again, sustainable. So most of the investments are happening long term. And, another angle that I see with sports investments, not only for football investments, they are, I was reading some article on LinkedIn the other day. They think it's a cool investment. Sports is a cool factor. Great. Yes, it is. But then you have to realize that sports is not going to give you returns in the short run. Forget football, any other sport. I think you will also agree with that, right? So that is something that investors also need to educate themselves before making an investment, whether it is East Bengal or with any other club. Due diligence is very, very critical. And they should understand why they are investing. If an investor really cannot answer the question convincingly that why am I investing into Indian football, whether it is in a club or any other kind of investment, whether it's an academy, etc. If they are not clear, that project more or less is going to fail.
Guys, before of course we continue this chat, our friend Anuj Gupta ko humne kya humne bait de diya, usne do aur comment de diya, Gupta hum nahi tera naam le rahe aur. But he's of course talking about young talent. He's saying that look, they need more games, and he's saying, let me tell you, all state-run clubs have enough money if it's spent on only domestic players. Meenu Jolly has joined us. Meenu, thanks for joining us. Even Delhi has a great state league structure. Get college students 18 to 21 year olds to play 15 to 20 games. Give them hope of promotion to I-League second division. That used to be the case for us when we used to play state league. They play to play amateur leagues anyway. Get them into the system. Football Delhi can conduct a yearly school league for under 16s, 18s. All of this has been thought of. All of this I've heard of for a long, long time. With a pathway, a player can also have serious talk at home to become a footballer. Ronak Jolly. Achha, Ronak, I guess you're using Meenu's account. So thanks for that. But guys, you know, you're talking about sustainable structure, Tathagat, because you can't ignore it. So, and what we've seen, given the proof and of people like Anuj and all, and what people are realizing, A, is that football, ke jo bachche hain, jo khelna chahte hain, wo badh raha hai. The ecosystem is going up. At least the desire to want to play and put on a Barcelona jersey and go out or an Arsenal jersey 5 years back, which no one people would wear now, but it's there, right? So now I think what everyone should do, and this is where your state teams can or state leagues can help, is that every local club should think of investing into a small academy type structure where kids come in, because you've all of course played football, local players who played football, you can coach them, take a certain amount of money from them, and that money can help you in sustaining a team playing in the state league. I think that is the only way forward. Uska aur koi tarika hai nahi, because it's a proven fact now. 5-6 saal se academies हमारे देश में काफी अच्छा कर रही है. एट अ स्मॉल स्केल लेवल, लार्ज स्केल लेवल, यू रियलाइजिंग दैट द वांट टू प्ले इन एकेडमी इज देयर एंड दे विलिंग टू पे टू प्ले इन एन एकेडमी. सो देन दैट मनी कैन बी यूज्ड टू सस्टेन अ टीम इन द स्टेट लीग. आईएसएल वाईएसएल तो छोड़ो, स्टेट लीग को हमने बढ़ाना है ना मजबूत. बात तो वही है
अर्जुन. आई थिंक अगेन आई एम कमिंग बैक टू माय फेवरेट टॉपिक व्हिच आई ऑलवेज से, आई थिंक देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग इन द मॉडल. देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग इन द मॉडल. That one way you are talking about new investors coming in, very fine. Thank you very much. All of you are welcome. But at the same time, somebody should tell me why investors who are there for 50 years are going out. Why Salgaonkar Club, which was formed in 1955, why Mahindra United, which was formed in 1960s, why JCT, which was formed in 1973, had to go out? Whenever these questions were asked, we received a very straightforward reply from the AFF, on the sly, of course, not officially. Oh, they had their business problems, so they are just taking it taking it as an excuse.
They've always said we don't see a long term plan.
So I am not convinced. None of us are convinced. You are also not convinced with the argument. So I am saying there is something wrong in the basic model. That's why our trusted investors who had been investing in football for the last 50, 60 years, when football was not such a fashionable game, there was not so much money in the game, there was not so much television, the coverage in the game, still they were there. And they were also losing money. Why they have gone out? That somebody has to answer this question. That is my question.
I don't know. I mean, I you guys both, Siddhant and Tathagat, either of you can get into this. I feel, jo ISL or I-League mein ho raha, usko maar do goli. Chhod do yaar. उसका अपने को कोई लेना देना नहीं है. वहां का बन गया सिस्टम. आपको अगर फोकस करना है तो नीचे फोकस करो ना. आई एग्री विद यू गाइस, ज्यादा फुटबॉल खेलना है, ज्यादा मैचेस खेलने हैं. वो जहां पे वो सिस्टम शुरू करोगे और इनवेरिएबली इट विल स्टार्ट इंपैक्टिंग व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ऑन द टॉप.
Yeah, and to going back to state leagues or regional leagues, whatever, however you do it. Now, as you go young, lower down the so-called whatever pyramid, right? Obviously, clubs will have less and less resources. Plus, also, you're dealing with younger children. So, you don't want to send necessarily like a 10-year-old all the way from Kashmir to Kanyakumari to play a football tournament. They should be playing jahan pe wo hain. Because it's not sustainable. Aap, theek hai, saal mein aapne ek trip kar liya hai kahin bahar. But usse zyada aap nahin kar payenge. To usi environment mein aapko khelna padega. Aur I think wo jo, yaar, right now, and what do fans then also put back into the game, right? So how is the European or like where football is popular, how does it work there? That fans also buy in and contribute to the financial health of the club, whatever it might be, right? So to achieve that, you have to have a very large fan base. And why East Bengal and Mohun Bagan are the most powerful players in Indian football? Because they are the only ones that have a fan base of passionate and a massive fan base. So therefore, they can say, no, this is how it should be and this is how we'll do it. Everyone can't do that. If you are running an academy, which is local community se ya local jo life hai usse koi connect nahi hai to kaise aapke fans aaye kahan se aapke fans aayenge. Niroka, for example, was a good example of this when they came into the I League. Even though Niroka is a local club that's based in one part of Imphal, it managed to, or FC Goa in the ISL, right, they managed to get together that all of which ATK also, I guess, had hoped that it would do when that franchise was started. And now, perhaps, at least they've gotten Mohun Bagan fans, so that'll help them. But unless you have that groundswell, that foundation, I don't think, like, nothing's going to happen with the national. I mean, as much as we might say sitting in our offices in Delhi that we'll qualify for the World Cup in 2026, we'll qualify for the Cup.
Favorite subject.
That's aise nahi hoga na.
Arjun, I wanted to tell you this thing only. You have played enough football. You know that Salgaonkar, or for that matter Dempo, or that for that matter JCT, had a huge fan base.
Yeah,
I'm not comparing with them with East Bengal or Mohun Bagan.
No,
maybe
sure.
East Bengal Mohun Bagan had a bigger fan base. Okay.
Yeah.
But these clubs had big fan base, you know.
Built over time.
Over time, thousands of people used to come. What did we get by destroying that fan base?
Fair enough. Can I just ask you, because you were part of the Dynamos and you were part of a new ownership of the Dynamos, did you kind of find out why the Den Network wanted to get out of the ISL, let go of a football team and thus sought for new owners to buy it?
I didn't exactly know the reason, but you know, it's not rocket science. You have to find out the reason. It's not sustainable. What are the losses that they were incurring? Any business house? It was huge, right? I mean, today also, if you talk about some of the P&Ls of the ISL teams, it's not a great reading from an investment perspective. Okay, it's today, of course, the bleeding has stopped to an extent. Last season, for the first time, I guess, the ISL teams received the revenues from the central pool were exceeding the franchisee fees that they were paying. So it was fantastic news. For the first time, it has overcome what they were paying, right, to the league. So, but that was not the situation 3 years back. They were losing a lot of money. So at the end of the day, again, that's a case of short-term investment, right? They thought that it's going to we'll recover all the money, jaldi se nikal lenge paise, but hua nahi hai. But at least unhone bech diya kisi aur. Right, they looked at capital gains. They did not gain anything possibly, but they did not lose either at the end of the day. So, that's possibly.
See,
can I ask you a quick follow-up to that? If you're saying that the revenue from the central pool is exceeding the franchisee fee,
yes,
then just as a theory, why not do away with the franchisee fee altogether and
Can I take it one more step? Having worked in the ISL, have you ever understood the reasoning behind charging a franchisee fee?
Not really, if you ask me. But possibly, I think the logic, and this is only speculation, could be wrong, right? The logic was that to sustain the organization of the league at that level with a lot of publicity, better organization maybe, you need money at the end of the day. And plus also, and this is again my second reason, is the exit barrier. If you have a franchisee fee, which you're paying for 10 years, you kind of create an exit barrier for the investor. You just cannot wrap up overnight and go. So at least it's some kind of a lock-in, right? For 10 years that I will be invested. Of course, you can sell it to some other owner, but the team will exist in some form. So what you have done is you've created an exit barrier, which is quite high. So just by wrapping up and leaving and closing the team is not going to happen. I think what happened, see, Pune City shut down and they moved to Hyderabad. Delhi migrated to Odisha, but the total number of teams are the same. You know, it did not become 8 from 10. It was 10-10, right? So, I think that is what is probably one of the logic to, you know, have that kind of franchise. But yes, coming to Siddharth, what you were saying, not have the franchisee fit at all, I think it's anyway going to stop after 3 years. Hmm. Whether it should happen now or possibly from the next season, that is a very interesting question. But I think that is very, very touchy when it comes to money, right? So,
No, fair enough. I'm just trying to understand what your take on the logic is. कि आप मैं आपको 10 रुपए दे रहा हूँ आप मुझे 11 रुपए वापस दे रहे हैं
हाँ,
तो फिर मैं
balance out हो जाता
है. Why is that exchange happening at all? And if we've already reached the stage where we are at that point, let's say at the where we are exchanging equal amounts or you are giving me more, then just say that okay, we will get a share of revenue and that's the end of that.
तो लेकिन उसमें एक angle और एक है. Franchisee fees basically from 10 teams average 15 crore अगर होता है 150 crores is assured for FSD.
Assured, yeah.
हाँ, वो तो एक assured revenue है, but जो central pool से आ रहा है, that may fluctuate. Now, for example, this COVID season,
yeah.
I'm sure lot of brands, whether it is at the club level or even at the league level, they are going to rework the numbers, possibly, because business, we are in a very bad situation, right? Businesses are in very bad situation. They're not earning a lot of money, so. Marketing spend is the first area that they are going to attack and prune it down. Now, if that is not enough to actually, give it back to the clubs, so 150 crores to assured enough, at least FSDL go. So I think that could be a play. That's one of the logic that I can see.
Possibly. I think it's the cool kids use that hashtag, you can't sit with us. वही वाला है कि आपके टेबल पे 10 जगह हैं तो यू हैव टू हैव सम क्राइटेरिया एंड बिकॉज़ ऑल ऑफ द प्लेयर्स आर बिग प्लेयर्स द मोस्ट सिंपल क्राइटेरिया दैट यू कम अप विद इज लाइक हु कैन बाय इन
इफ यू इट्स लाइक
प्लेइंग अप एट अ पोकर टेबल राइट देयर इज अ
बाय इन बट यू आल्सो हैव टू एग्री विद व्हाट तथागत इज सेइंग दैट दिस आल्सो देन मींस दैट यू कांट कम इन फॉर 1 ईयर एंड से ओ तेरी यहां पे तो 40 करोड़ गए और मिला तो मुझे 1 रुपए वापस तो चलो जी
But I think that can be done without a franchise. You can, like, in your when you have a whatever your corporate structure or whatever, like a league membership, you have to join the league, you have to, I suppose, sign some sort of agreement. It doesn't have to be linked to money. You can when you sign, when if I sign a contract to be your friend for 10 years, and if I want to, like, they have to have
a, didn't sign a contract. Have to be behind the curtains.
No. All I'm saying is there doesn't have to be a money clause involved to involve that part. Because, and like we've seen, man, like, you look at even a random club like AFC Wimbledon, right? The number of owners that in their 100-year history or whatever history they might have, how many different owners have come? Because my only point on that was that clubs, I don't think, die. Football clubs don't die. Franchises have a chance of dying because franchise has, it's like a McDonald's. It's an outlet. Like Mohan Bagan, East Bengal, आप जहाँ मर्जी खिला दो उनको मेरे backyard में अगर आप खिला दो तब भी वो लोग देखने आ जाएंगे या जो दो चार फैन जो भी कोई the club will survive in one form or the other.
What will happen to
Arjun
Singh now? Are they playing?
Sir, Jaydeep sir, आप तो मैं कह रहा हूँ इस शो पे आप नीचे
East Bengal's lover. another week from now, they will be 100 years.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So what will be in their fate this season? Where they are playing?
Good question, Jaydeep. It's sad, no? It's very, very sad for a club. I'm a fan of that club. It's very sad that they are going through this situation.
But isn't it sad that they have...
So Tathagat, sorry to interrupt, Jaydeep. Just like, as an East Bengal fan and someone who's been involved with the club for a while, what is the sort of chit-chat, like we're sitting and talking about football on Sunday, a bunch of you East Bengal guys must be sitting around and doing the same. What is the kind of conversation, discussions, possibilities that you guys are talking about?
Well, I mean, I have never seen such a polarized view, at least on what are the conversations that I follow, at least online. Social media is the best way to follow online what's happening, at least with the fans. There's a big polarized view. Some want to, you know, some say they have taken the idealist position. We will not play in the ISL. We'll continue with the I-League. Some say, no, we should play in the ISL. And probably that has happened because of the pressure that Mohan Bagan has gone there. Right. So it's a very tricky time to be an East Bengal fan. You really don't know what you should be supporting. And right now, at the end of the day, a fan is a fan. They want the team to be playing at the highest league. So today the ISL is the top league. So we need to play there.
So as a fan, you're saying that you are on that side that wants to play the ISL,
correct?
Right?
Yeah. I want to see East Bengal play Mohan Bagan. At the national stage in a top league.
Yeah.
I want to experience the two derbies.
So, maybe this is not necessary, but like, what is the counter argument to that? Like, why would any East Bengal fan not want that derby to be limited only the Calcutta League?
See, I really don't know, Siddhant. I think what's happening is there is a perception probably that if you play in the ISL, and unfortunately, what is happening is that the demand, because of the franchisee fee and it's very difficult for East Bengal to just jump into ISL through a direct entry, right? I mean, Mohan Bagan also did not get into ISL on its own. They had to merge with ATK.
The existing team, yeah.
Yeah. So, it's a very idealistic situation that what some fans say, don't give control to a corporate body. And probably their experience that they had recently with Quest, etc., they felt that, if you give control to a third party, they will not run the team well. So there are a lot of, ifs and buts, a lot of doubts. So, and especially East Bengal after having this divorce with Quest recently, it has not been a great experience probably. So they are very skeptical.
I like the way you said divorce because it's funny because a lawyer is the one guy who's commenting the most on our show. He's a dear friend, of course, Anuj. Anuj and Ronak Jolly, guys, thanks so much for commenting. Guys, we've done more than an hour. Does anyone have any final comments? Then I'll close the show after that. I'll start with you, Jaideep, sir.
See, on 3+1, I'm again saying it's what I said. I thought it's a knee-jerk reaction. There was no point in going with the AFC line suddenly. Number of teams should be increased more. Because I have seen the Indian players, great Indian players emerging in a club, in a league where five foreigners were used. It depends on, of course, limited number of foreigners should be used. But that doesn't mean that football will improve. More and more teams, more and more play. And as you just said half an hour ago, more matches. That is most important. Match time is most important. That's what I would say. And as far as this thing is concerned, which my view had been always been the same, and now the same, that there is something wrong in the model.
Fair enough. Tathagat, the final words?
Well, for the national team, be patient. Whatever, 3+1 is just one lever. There are multiple levers that you need to pull to really ensure that, the impact is there at the national level, at least at the national team level. Quality is also important. Quantity is yes, we need more games, but also the quality of the games. Quality of our players is very, very critical. Also, don't forget, while we have talked about the league at the domestic level, we have to also look at the international games level. We need to play more international games, right? Japan or even a South Korea. Let's look at Asian teams. They try to utilize as many FIFA dates as possible in a non-COVID world. I'm not talking about a COVID situation. So we need to play a lot of quality games as well. So it's both quantity, quality that you need to focus on.
Anji sir, bataiye.
Sir, I'm in agreement with what everyone is saying. I think this changing one rule, that's why we also kept it kind of generic. like overall structure, rule changes, how will they impact the national team and in the long run? And I think now a couple of articles I've seen in the past couple of days talking about how there are some Indian players, and we've been talking about it a lot. It's time for us to look at Indian players going out and playing, getting more exposure in leagues outside of India. And I think that will have a much more immediate and much more sort of pronounced impact on the results of the national team, rather than worrying too much about what's happening here. Because several coaches back-to-back, and I think Tathagat, you'd probably agree, have maintained that the quality of competition domestically, in fact, you did just say exactly this, the quality of domestic competition that we have in India today is not going to create a national team that's going to be able to compete with the best in Asia anytime soon. So we have to focus on strengthening the domestic league structure, no doubt. That's the only way a national team can get better in the long run. Or we do then thoda hera feri, kisi ke saath koi side deal kar le, some country that has a strong league, you know, maybe assign two players from there. Because why are foreign players attracted to India? Because now ISL clubs are paying good money, like really good money for them to come and play, which they are not getting in Europe, you know. So on similarly, that, do a flip kind of thing, arrangement where Indian players receive a stipend from maybe the AIFF or whatever, but get a chance to go and play in Mexico or play in Uruguay for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, whatever, you know. And let's not only look at the Premier League and Spain and like these three countries.
Which Venkatesh has said yesterday, the same thing, isn't it? Our assistant coach Venkatesh has also said, na? At least there are eight, nine Indian players who should go out of this country and play in a J League second division or K League second division or somewhere like that, or in UAE or somewhere like that.
So, ठीक है, अगर आपके पास आज structure नहीं है, games नहीं मिल रहे हैं, तो at these levels, I think, and countries like Japan, I think, have more friendly visa regimes vis-a-vis India. So, there are definitely possibilities.
उसपे एक अलग सा session करो. उसमें then the economics come into play. That can be a separate one-hour discussion actually.
But अगर जो आप लोग हमारा show देख रहे हैं, we started with 28, अभी 13 लोग देख रहे हैं, hopefully YouTube पे ज़्यादा लोग देखेंगे. हमने यहाँ पे जो बातचीत करी है कि these changes that have been brought about, will it have a direct impact on the national team? तो एक किताब और pen है, क्योंकि भाई काफी चीजें बदलने वाली होंगी, तभी वो impact होगा. एक 3+1 होने से impact नहीं होगा. पर जैसे कि आप घर की बात करें ना, घर की मरम्मत में प्लम्बिंग करानी पड़ेगी, पाइप बदलने पड़ेंगे, बिजली करानी पड़ेगी, सीपेज होगी, सीपेज के बाद पानी के लिए पंप लगाना पड़ेगा, लाइन से खींचने के लिए और ऊपर चढ़ाने के लिए. तो मतलब काम बहुत है यहाँ पे. बट आई थिंक द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, एंड दिस इज अ वेरी नाइस पॉइंट, दैट इन द शॉर्ट टर्म इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव अ डायरेक्ट इम्पैक्ट ऑन द नेशनल टीम, से 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, then what are the kind of steps that need to be taken? And the points that you guys have brought about in the end, that start sending players abroad, that can have a short-term impact on the national team straight away. Tathagat, thank you so much for joining us. Siddhant and Jaideep, as always, guys, pleasure. Just a reminder for all of you, every Sunday at 2 p.m. Okay. We're going to be going live on NewsClick's Facebook page. So do start joining us. Ye 13 logon ki fauj, matlab respect to you. Par aur log aana chahiye na, sharam karo yaar yahan pe. Comments
mein likhe tha. It's enough to start a football club though.
So theek hai bhai. हमारा भाई पॉजिटिव आदमी है, तो हम पॉजिटिव तरीके से बोलेंगे. मच लव टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर वॉचिंग, एंड जस्ट रिमेंबर, इफ यू वांट टू हैव अ कॉन्वर्सेशन विद अस, यू वांट टू थ्रो इन क्वेश्चंस एट अस, डू मेक श्योर यू जॉइन अस देन, बिकॉज वी ऑफ कोर्स विल ट्राई टेकिंग ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसरिंग देम. यू हैव बीन वॉचिंग अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ 420 ग्राम्स. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय.